Greetings, everyone, and welcome back to Microsoft's Java for Beginners series. My name is Brian Benz, and I'm a cloud advocate at Microsoft. I'm joined by Mark Heckler, who's going to give us an overview of Java. Mark, do you want to tell us a little bit about yourself and about Java?
Sure. Thanks, Brian. My name is Mark Heckler. I'm a principal cloud advocate of Java and JVM languages at Microsoft, and we're here today to talk about Java. Let's start by talking about Java the language, and then we'll continue talking about Java the platform. Next, we'll discuss the native executable or binary option for Java deployments. And then finally, how Java is start to finish community driven and why all of that is important for you as a Java developer. First, the language. Java is strongly typed, but it doesn't suffer a lot of the frustrations that perhaps if you're coming from a loosely typed language that you might expect, because it does offer a lot of power and flexibility to, again, put the power into you, the developer's, hands. Just a few examples of that. Very quick examples, but I like to show them because, again, that helps you get a better understanding, I feel like, as a developer of what I'm talking about. The generics offer the compiler and tools the ability to work for you on your behalf. The diamond operator, again, supports type inference. So when you have a variable that's defined of a list of type string, for instance, you don't have to respecify that array list that you're creating, constructing, as a type string. The compiler and the tools understand that. You also have things like local variable type inference. So you can assign an object of a certain type to a variable, and the compiler and the tools understand exactly what that type of that variable should be. Pattern matching, again, simplifies your code, and the compiler steps in and helps you a lot with that as well. You also have things like, in terms of capabilities of Java, Java is very expressive. And by that expressive, I mean readable, because as they say, the compiler reads your code once, you read your code over and over and over again, because we as developers write our code, we also have to read it, maintain it, understand it as we change it, and make sure that we don't break things as we go along. Something like this, and again, this is a very simple example, but it's very clear exactly what's happening. You have a default value that you're assigning to a variable, and if in the constructor, a different value is passed in that is valid, anything over zero in length, then that value is assigned to that variable. And then, of course, with a greet method, we're just greeting the person as requested. Java is object-oriented in its foundation. However, it also has functional capabilities as well, kind of the best of both worlds in that regard as well. So, when you are entirely in the object-oriented camp or entirely in the functional camp, once again, you can see advantages or discrepancies in terms of things you would like to have that may not necessarily be within your chosen realm. So Java incorporates kind of the best of both worlds. You have things like sealed classes. Sealed classes give you the ability to control inheritance and control the extension of those classes and interfaces as well, so that you don't have this kind of uncontrolled landscape in terms of what can be done with classes that you define or interfaces, again, that you define. So we have here a sealed class called rectangle that permits extension via a square, and we can inherit that, we can extend that rectangle to create a square class, which cannot be extended from that point forward. And in terms of functional characteristics, you have the ability to create immutable collections or immutable entities of various different forms, pass them down through a chain of operations, and to maintain that immutability as actions are taken when that grouping of entities is passed throughout that chain to be processed. Java is also incredibly backward compatible, which may not be important for new code that you're writing. However, eventually it will be, but it's certainly very important for older code that you're maintaining on behalf of your organization. There are many cases where very, very, very old code that's absolutely essential to an organization is being rebuilt, recompiled, rerun using current versions of the Java virtual machine, and everything just works, either with zero changes or with absolutely minimal changes. And that's critically important for a language that has a 25-year history. Most languages have a lot of history, and many languages sadly break that compatibility several times as they continue to evolve, not Java. So in terms of the Java platform, typically is built around the JVM, the Java Virtual Machine. That's the most common scenario. When you create a Java application, you build it, you deploy it, it's typically using a JVM. The Java compiler in this case compiles to bytecode rather than native platform-specific code. There is a just-in-time compiler that often yields better than native performance in terms of a deployable artifact, sometimes slightly worse, sometimes slightly better. It averages out roughly native performance, even with the JVM. And it runs anywhere there is a JVM. So any new platform, any new container format or what have you, it all runs. Your Java application will run there as long as there's been a JVM created, which is an incredibly powerful tool to put to work on your behalf with no effort on your part. There's also a native option. And of course, as you might imagine, with a native option that's platform specific, it takes longer to build, but it gives incredibly fast startup times, again, as you might imagine with a native option, with very low resource requirements. It gives you another way to deploy Java applications depending on your specific use case. Java is 100% community driven. It's 100% open source. You have many different organizations and vendors and providers who offer up a build of the Open Java Developers Kit, the JDK. And they may make different choices in terms of garbage collection or optimizations, but you are aware of what those are, and you can transport your code, your applications from one to the other in nearly every case with zero modifications, just potentially different outcomes, for instance, with the garbage collection pauses and different trade-offs that you might choose to embrace for particular targeted use cases. The Java community process allows you to be involved as an individual, as an organization, as a corporation, whatever. As an individual, you can join in and contribute to the discussion, contribute to specifications and specification requests. You can discuss and evolve those specifications. And once those specifications are approved, voted on or approved, they are provided with a reference implementation and a technology compatibility kit, a TCK, which allows you to test early and test often and verify that the implementation that you want to provide or use works. And if not, that's fed back in prior to finalization and release into the Java language as a finalized version. So in summary, Java is much more than just a language, although it is a great language. Java also is a platform. Java provides a native binary option for deployability, and it's also 100% community-driven start to finish. With that, all I have left to say is, go Java.
Thanks, Mark. That was great. Please check out the other topics in Microsoft's Java for Beginners series.
Thanks so much.